I stuck by ya. You're a sunflower. I think your love will be too much.
Welcome everyone to this week's episode of Unrooted Softball Edition. And my guest for this week's show is none other than sophomore third baseman on the softball team here at Menlo College, Katelyn Magana. Katelyn, thanks so much for joining on the show.
Thank you for having me here.
You're very welcome. Let's start by talking a little bit about yourself. Now, this was at some point last year, but I was told by one of your teammates that you aren't necessarily the best artist, but that you have perfected the stick figure drawing. Is that correct?
I wouldn't say I've perfected it, because sometimes I draw stick figures and sometimes the legs are a little bit longer than the other, but I just draw shoes over them to like distract the fact that they're longer than the other, so I'm getting there.
What does a shoe on a stick figure person look like? Because I don't think I've ever seen that in my life.
I think it's just like a circle. You just draw like an X so it looks like shoelaces.
Well, how adorable. How long have you been doing the stick figure game?
As long as I can do it. When they say draw somebody, it's usually stick figure for me, nothing else.
Well, to be fair, drawing people is very difficult.
Yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't consider myself an artiste by any stretch, but drawing people was always the most difficult thing for me to do. I can draw other things sometimes, but I can't. People, forget about it. I'm right there with you. Like, stick figures would probably be the best thing that I could do. How are you artistic in other ways, perhaps?
I don't think so. Everything's misshapen when I try to draw it, or they just don't look like what it's supposed to be. So I don't think I'm artistic in any way, probably.
Well, they're unique impressions by Katelyn Magana, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, at least you have that working for you.
Yeah.
They are your own. They are unique.
Yeah.
But that's okay. You don't necessarily need to be artistic. You just need to play softball.
Yeah.
Because that's why you are here.
That's why I'm here.
And you do a good job at that. So at least you have that going for you. Now, your hometown of Tustin is right in the heart of Orange County. And there's so much to do around the surrounding area. I know you didn't get a chance probably to go home for spring break. Or maybe you did. I don't know. Did you?
No, I didn't get a chance
okay.
to.
Okay. Bummer. But if you would have gone home for spring break, what would you have done with time on your hands and obviously the beach like right there?
Yeah, usually I would go to the beach, but when the weather back home was pretty like stormy too, so if it were sunny I would go to the beach, but I would probably go to Disneyland with a couple friends since it's just down the road for me.
Hard to go wrong there.
Yeah.
Now, earlier I think it was in November, I drove through Tustin for the NAIA Men's Soccer National Championships in Irvine. And I saw a, like, giant hangar type thing.
Oh, yeah.
What is that?
It used to be, like, a base there and just all the airplanes. But they're getting rid of that now and, like, creating parks there and, like, new shopping centers. But that's pretty much all I know of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I that's the only thing I know that's in Tustin, as a matter of fact, because I drove through and I thought, hey, Katelyn's from here. And then I saw this giant hangar. I'm like, what the heck is that? Maybe she'll know about that. That's all I guess we really need to know about it if it's going away.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the team now. Last weekend, the Oaks played Simpson University for four games on Friday and Sunday. Are these games against really great competition important for you ladies as you transition into regular conference play?
I think they're very important, because playing these ranked teams means it's a lot more competition. And even though some of the games didn't end as well as we wanted to, that lit a fire under us to like do better for season. And the games that we did win, it showed us that we were capable of doing these things and playing as a team and then playing for each other to win the games in conference, because it'll be like similar competition.
Yeah, and that fire was definitely lit yesterday on Monday as the Oaks went up to Rockland and took on Jessup, and you smacked them. You scored 24 runs over two games. What changed in that Monday doubleheader? Was there like a conversation before the game, or what all of a sudden turned things around in an instant?
We had two conversations. One was with the coaches and one was with the team. But basically it was about, we need to do something to fix this now, and then who's going to be the one to do it. And if we're going to be the one to do it, we have to get everyone on board and do it as a team.
And that's exactly what happened with the 16-2 win in game one and then 8-6 in game number two. Part of the reason the Oaks have been so successful offensively has been the play of Lauren Harrison at the top of the order. I mean, she's hitting practically .500 on the season. Mm-hmm. What have you seen from her game this season that has really elevated to take her to the next level?
Lowe has definitely gone off this season. And I think what plays a big part of that is her confidence. And I say that because when she goes up to bat, she knows she has a job to do and she's going to do it. And that when she's hitting, she's going to find a way to get on base no matter what, because she's thinking about the team and not just for herself.
Yeah, and again, she's been stellar to begin the season. So really, it seems like every time she goes up, she does get on base or get a base hit. Now this weekend, the Oaks have a very tough task. You're taking on two of the top ranked teams, not only in the GSAC, but in the entire NAIA, in Vanguard and Hope. What do you know about these two teams, and what's the plan this weekend to take them down?
I think the plan this weekend is to play our game. And one thing our coaches are very big on is nameless, faceless opponents. So right now, we don't want to know the name. We don't want to know the record. We're just going to play our game, because the game doesn't know who won or who lost the game before, or in like stats. Mm-hmm. So if we just do what we know, we'll be able to do anything.
Well said. All right, let's get into the final segment of the show now, Katelyn. It's called Brownie Bites. I'm going to ask you three off-the-wall questions. Give me your best answers.
Okay.
Question number one, which teammate is most likely to make their own comic book?
I think Morgan Zimmerman would most likely be the one to make a comic book, because she's very into like superhero movies, and then she just regular, really funny person. So I think reading those comic books would be like a good laugh.
Do you think she would star in her own comic book?
I think she would. She'd be like the main one, probably.
The main superhero.
Yes.
Yeah, I can see that. Question number two. This one inspired by the giant hangar in Tustin, which probably is completely irrelevant. But which teammate would most likely be the one to fly a blimp one day?
I was talking about this with my roommate, Gina, and I think it would be her, because I can imagine her flying a blimp, and it would be like a picture of her face saying, "I love Jeannie," because that's like the nickname that we all give her. So I think it would definitely be Gina.
With Regina, it really comes down to this. Why not?
Yeah.
Like that, if you could answer any of these with Regina, and the reasoning for it would just be, why not?
Yeah.
She would do it. Then question number three, if you could pick one teammate to skydive with, who would it be and why?
I would pick Malia, because she's probably one of my best friends on the team and on this campus. And just being with her is a fun time, and probably watching her jump out of an airplane with me would probably be the funniest thing in my life.
So you think jumping out of an airplane would actually be funny?
Like, not for me. I'm just going to forget the part that I'm jumping out and just focus on her.
Okay, fair enough. Would you actually do it, though?
I have, like, this terrible fear of heights, so probably not.
Yeah.
If I had the choice.
I don't have a fear of heights, but I have a fear of, I guess I would say, falling out of a plane.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I don't care how high up I am. I have no desire to willingly just, I don't want to say risk my life, because it's fairly safe, but, well, fairly safe.
Yeah.
But, like, I just have no desire to be free falling out of the sky.
Either.
I don't care if I'm with my best friend. Like, I'm just not doing that. You could not. If I was with my best friend, no, because my best friend would probably push me out of the plane.
That's probably something Malia would do too, to get me out of the plane. Yeah.
Well, then you wouldn't be laughing at that point.
No,
you'd
be fearing for my life.
Screaming, probably saying a few things that we can't repeat on the show.
Yeah,
that's exactly what would happen. Katelyn, thanks for joining me on the show.
Thank you for having me.
You're welcome, folks. The softball team there on the road this weekend, and they take on two of the top 15 ranked teams in the NAIA. They take on Vanguard on Friday in Costa Mesa, and then they take on 7th-ranked Hope International University. That doubleheader is set for Saturday, and they'll return back home the following week, Thursday and Friday, at Wunderlich Field. We invite you to tune into next week's episode of Unrooted Softball Edition, when Katelyn Magana will select the next interviewee by me, Brian Brownfield, right here on the show. Until then, we'll see you next time. Take care, everyone.
Then you're left in the dust, unless I stuck by you. You're a sunflower. I think your love would be too much.